Hey guys, FX Hummel here, thanks for watching. What you're about to see is some footage from my time up at Sig Sauer. I was fortunate enough to get some one-on-one training with Steve Gilchrist at the Sig Sauer Academy. He would demonstrate some drills that they do at the Academy, and then I'd try to do them in my comparatively very, very slow way, although I'm really excited to start incorporating these drills into my own training and get better at them. Also, he talks about their ideas on front sight and trigger reset, the Sig P320 versus the 226. You'll see me shoot some of the cool new Sig guns like the MPX and the MCX Suppress the 300 Blackout. So I hope you enjoy this footage of my time up at Sig Sauer. Hey guys, I'm here with Steve from Sig Sauer, and we spent some time on the range yesterday talking about some techniques. And one of them was, we talked about the front sight, and you think about it in a little bit different way than I've been taught. And you say float the dot,
shoot the shot.
Okay, so can you talk a little bit about
that? What we want to do is refine that process of our sight alignment to sight picture, and then that whole integrated delivery of the shot. So everybody understands rear sight, front sight, and we have to have sight alignment, and then we put that image onto a target, and that's our sight picture. Well, what happens is a beginner shooter goes through that process one step at a time. All right, I have my rear sight, I have my front sight, I put that on the target, and then I can go ahead and take the shot. Well, what we want to do is get them to bring that process forward to a smooth process that uses their natural abilities. And what we have is our human eye has the ability with our central vision to naturally center things. And so by focusing on the front sight, we say float the dot, because we have a night sight dot on there, so we say float the dot, shoot the shot. What happens is the shooter now just lets their natural ability to center things of seeing that dot on the center of the target of which they want to engage. And so what happens, we get them through drills to have instant success of just finding that dot on the target. Now obviously, depending on the degree of difficulty of that target, they might have to adjust their central vision to focus more on that dot or less, depending on, again, the degree of difficulty. But by just floating the dot or just looking for the dot, we're using that natural ability to center things, and now they can get to getting onto that trigger and delivering shots a lot faster. So float the dot, shoot the shot, it's just our way of getting them to have a quick and easy way to deliver that shot without having to go through a whole lengthy, rear sight, front sight, equal light, distance, and all that stuff that we normally talk about. It's a simple process, float the dot, shoot the shot, and it's quick and easy.
That is pretty sweet. One other thing that really helped me a lot was we were talking about trigger reset yesterday.
Yeah.
And, before I got here yesterday, I pressed the trigger to the rear, hold it, wait for the gun to do whatever it's going to do, and then reset the trigger, and then take the next shot.
Yeah.
Can you talk a little bit about, kind of how we tweaked that to take away all the extra motion?
Absolutely. So, again, what we first look at is we want the gun to fit the shooter's hand, and then as far as finger placement becomes important, it's just place the finger where it can kind of comfortably or naturally lie on the trigger. Again, we don't get caught up in exactly where you put it. We keep it objective based in that you need to be able to press the trigger to the rear without adding additional motion to the muzzle. If you can accomplish that, your rounds are going to hit the target. Now, with that being said, we look at now that process of pressing that trigger for each and every shot. Mechanically, we have to press the trigger. The gun has to go through its cycle of operation. And we have to allow the trigger to reset so we can fire the next shot. So a step-by-step process of that would be if I held to the rear, the gun would cycle, and then I would reset and feel and hear the click, and that'd be kind of doing it at a basic level. But again, we want to advance that process or make it smoother, and what we see is once the bullet leaves the gun, now the cycle of operation begins where the side starts to cycle. During that process, we go ahead and reset during recoil, and that allows us to let the gun go through its cycle of operation of cycling the slide, chambering the next round, but our finger is already let the trigger reset, and now we go back to our start position, and then we don't get caught up and you have to maintain contact or anything like that. We just get that reset done and get back to that. As soon as my sights are on target, when I can float that dot, my finger and that trigger is already reset and I'm ready to take that next shot. So basically refine that process, make it smooth, reset during recoil, as opposed to pausing and waiting for the gun to finish its cycle of operation. We just get it all done at one step. So we're doing all the same steps, but we're getting it done in one step versus all individual steps each time.
Okay. My last question is the Sig P320.
Yeah.
Right? I noticed you carry the 226, yeah. And I'm assuming you've been carrying that for a really long time.
I have.
Okay.
So I have the option of shooting any one of our guns here. We did do some of the initial testing, and we give continuous feedback to the factory here at the Academy about the weapon systems. The only reason I'm carrying a 226 is because we have a lot of folks out there that come to classes that have double action guns or double single or single action. So I choose the DASA, kind of the flagship gun of the company as well, the 226, you know, with the NSW and things like that. So I just carry that out of personal preference. I've just, from law enforcement, I've always had it. But the 320, we also, what we do is when new guns come out or as we're testing, we'll run that gun through all our classes and test it. And so I ran that gun for about 5 months straight. Loved it. That's my new concealed carry gun. Mm-hmm. It's the 320 compact. So we love the gun. We've been very happy with it, with its performance, and there's going to be more changes coming out to it to add more options, different size grip modules and things like that. So we're really excited about that gun. Again, it's just you know, personal preference. I just like the 226. Nothing more than that.
Okay, great. Thanks a lot, man.
Absolutely.
I appreciate it. Yeah.
My pleasure.
Thanks.
Load up. Ready to go.
I believe so. I gotta show that press check to the the guys down in Tennessee. They'll love that. All right. And that's it. That is a sweet gun. That really is, though.